We're learning about an email sent by the former President Barack Obama reprimanding his former White House physician, Ronny Jackson, who was also the personal doctor for George W. Bush and Donald Trump. Obama wrote the email during the 2020 campaign between Trump and Joe Biden, scolding Jackson for tweeting criticism of Biden's cognitive health. Here's part of Obama's email. He said, "I've made a point of not commenting on your service in my successor's administration and have always spoken highly of you both in public and in private. You always served me and my family well, and I have considered you not only a fine doctor and service member, but also a friend. That's why I have to express my disappointment at the cheap shot you took at Joe Biden via Twitter. It was unprofessional and beneath the office that you once held. It was also disrespectful to me and the many friends you had in our administration. You were the personal physician to the President of the United States as well as an admiral in the U.S. Navy. I expect better, and I hope upon reflection that you will expect more of yourself in the future." Now, Obama acted after Jackson retweeted a video of Biden along with this message. "Remember the cognitive test that I gave Donald Trump, the one he aced? Sounds like somebody else might need some testing done. Scary." Let's discuss now. CNN medical analyst Dr. Jonathan Reiner is here, and political commentator David Swerdlick, senior staff editor at New York Times Opinion. Good to see both of you. David, there's a lot of trolling in politics.
Yeah.
Why do you think Obama felt the need to respond?
I think he was trying to do the right thing, but I think, Don, in this case, President Obama miscalculated for two reasons. One reason is that no matter his intentions, it comes across as if he's saying, please don't pick on my friend. President Biden, then Vice President Biden, can defend himself. He defended himself by winning that election. Now that this letter is out, it kind of makes him look a little bit weaker that Obama was interceding on his behalf. The other miscalculation, Don, is that President Obama in that letter, again, despite his intentions, got away from what made him so successful in politics. When he was running for president, they called him everything but a child of God. What did he do? Brush your shoulder
off.
When they said, hey, where's your flag pin? He didn't give a sermon. He just put on the flag pin. Never came off. And I think in that way, he got away from what helped him win two decisive presidential victories. But on the merits, he's obviously right. Congressman Jackson, that tweet was grimy. He was pandering to try and win an election.
And he also gave him, a selling point for his book because, right?
Exactly. He's gonna dine out on this letter for the rest of his career.
Yeah. Don't give him oxygen. So, Dr. Reiner, Jackson's comments were public. Obama's were not until Jackson wrote about it in his book. Why do you think President Obama reached out to him via email? Is it something about a doctor-patient relationship? Possibly?
Well, he was betrayed. I think the former president felt betrayed. Ronny Jackson did something that is almost unheard of amongst White House physicians, and I've had the honor of knowing several. Look, when you are the physician for the President of the United States, you are entrusted with the president's life, and the president puts his trust in you. And you also become part of the administration. I think the former president felt betrayed. Mr. Jackson has shown himself to be a consummate opportunist. He curried favor with President Obama so he could become promoted to admiral. He then gave that famous press conference during the Trump administration in 2018 when he basically called the former President Trump basically an Adonis who could live to 200. That got him nominated. That got him nominated to become VA secretary. And then in 2020, he attacked Mr. Biden, which basically got the former president, Trump, to support his candidacy for Congress. So he showed himself willing to basically do what he has to do to achieve his goal, regardless of what the ethics are. And I think the former President Obama was deeply offended by it.
This has played out, this all played out in February of 2020. There were plenty of Democrats still in the field to become the Democratic nominee for president. Was this about Ronny Jackson doing a solid for his latest patient, Donald Trump? That's for you, David.
I think it was, just like Dr. Reiner said. He knew that running for Congress, he wanted to have the support of then President Trump. He knew that President Trump and a lot of people that they share in their political base like this sort of owning the libs style.
He's an opportunist, as opportunist, Dr. Reiner just
said. And it's an easy target. I don't want to dip into your lane, Dr. Reiner, but if correct me if I'm wrong, I don't think physicians, of which Congressman Jackson is, and a former flag officer, aren't supposed to even have the appearance of diagnosing someone from afar on anything like their cognition. It's just, it's not appropriate for a doctor to do. Add on that he was the White House physician when Biden was vice president.
Mm-hmm. You want to respond to that, doctor?
Well, that's absolutely right. I think he mischaracterized himself as having some sort of inside knowledge about and Vice President Biden when, in fact, I don't think he ever examined Mr. Biden when he was in office. And even more recently, he's characterized himself that way with former Vice President Cheney, when he basically asserted that he was a physician caring for the former vice president, but still felt the need to speak out against Liz Cheney. So he has shown himself willing to say basically anything. Look, this past November, he called Omicron a Democratic, midterm election trick. So he has shown himself, willing basically to, throw away any ethic that he might have had when he was a physician and in order to achieve some sort of political goal.
Yeah. Well, look, this has been the era of the opportunist and the grifter, and there are a lot of them out there. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Thanks,
both of you.